Now, one of the interesting things about the Tokugawa era is that it was a relatively closed era, right? That it was
right.
not an era in which they welcomed the disrupting force of European influence.
Right.
But they did have one safety valve, right? They did have
right.
Nagasaki. So can
That's
you tell
right.
us a bit about that?
That's right. The word closed country is a misnomer for Tokugawa mm-hmm. Japan, but it was tightly regulated,
mm-hmm.
and it was relatively closed. So that there was a trade route to Korea through an island of Tsushima, and there was a trade route from one domain, Satsuma, down to Okinawa. But the main other one is Nagasaki, as you said. And there were two groups who traded there. The Chinese merchants had an outpost there, and the only Westerners who were there were the Dutch.
Not only did goods come in and out of Nagasaki, but ideas came as well. Can you tell us a bit about that?
That's right. And there was a trade both in Chinese and in Western language ideas. And from the Dutch, who brought in books in various languages, but primarily Dutch, the books the Japanese were primarily interested in were astronomy as a science for navigation and also medicine.
So it's through that city opening that the knowledge, both of the Dutch and probably even more importantly of the Chinese, makes its way into
right.
Into,
right. And the town. Nagasaki environs had some economic impact from having this trade in this port, more so than other areas. And some products were coming in from the West. Glass was highly valued. Ceramics was something that was exported from Nagasaki to Europe, and the Japanese ceramic industry in the environs of Nagasaki mm-hmm. grew up and also began to manufacture things that they knew the European aristocracy liked.
But since Nagasaki is the only port, you don't have a lot of large-scale cities growing up around ports the way that you do in the West, right?
I mean, that's right.
Every one of our older American cities is built on a major waterway precisely
right.
because of that. But this isn't happening in Tokugawa.
That's right. It's not happening at all. And so the pattern of economic development more generally in Japan in the Tokugawa period that's sort of counterintuitive or unusual comparatively is rural-centered. The economy is growing. There's peace. There is relative unity of currency, although not perfectly so, but mm-hmm. there's the ability to trade between cities and the countryside. But the demand was being generated between cities and the countryside, not between the countryside to cities to the rest of the world.